So welcome friends, and today's lecture we will discuss about the basics of chemistry. Many persons, many students, many friends complain that they are not able to understand chemistry. Even they study very deeply, they give much time, but didn't get the concept of the chemistry. Usually thinks, what are the reason behind it? I thought that their basics is not completed. If the basics is not completed, then you will face a lot of challenges to understand the chemistry, and it will be more and more difficult to understand the chemistry. So in this lecture, we will understand the basics of chemistry, which is very, very essential for understanding the concept, for understanding this subject. So first we discuss the, we come to the topic. We discuss the volume. First is volume. Second is mass. Third is weight. So we will understand these topics one by one. What is volume? So what is volume? First, understanding the volume, we should understand what are the 3D objects. You already know, I think you already know the what are the 3D objects. 3D, according to the name, it is showing 3D. 3 means 3, D means dimensional. The object which has three dimensions are called 3D objects. 3D means what 3D means. We go in some deep to understand the dimension 3D objects. 3D objects. For understand 3D objects, we already know those objects which have length, height, and breadth. Length, breadth, and height. If the objects have length, breadth, and height, those objects are called 3G objects. And if you see that every object which you touch, which you can't hold, which you can't catch, has the 3D objects. If we can take the duster, this duster has length, breadth, and height. 3D object, we can hold it. 3D object, we can hold it. What is 2D object? 2D object only has length and breadth. Doesn't height. Length and breadth. This object has length and breadth. Doesn't height. So if the object has only length and breadth, that object is called 2D objects. And those objects which have length, breadth, and height, those objects are called 3D objects. And in our world, only 3D objects are occurred. And to touch only 3D objects is possible. To hold only 3D object is possible. And now we come on the topics. Volume. What is volume? And we will take the example of one 3D object. You take the example of duster. As we discussed now, duster is the example of 3D objects. Another object you can say, cube. You already know how to draw the cube. So cube is also a 3D object. So this is 3D objects. This is 3D objects, right? So these are the cube have the 3D objects. Means come to the topic, what is volume? Volume is the amount of space occupied in a certain 3D objects. Means a certain 3D objects which occupies a certain amount of space is called volume. Volume means a space occupied by 3D objects. And the unit of the volume is meter cube. Means meter cube, that means it has length, it has breadth, and it has height. So is the unit is becomes 3D objects. Meter cube is a unit of the volume. And we come to the topic, next topic is mass. What do you mean by mass? Everything, amount of matter present in the body. So what amount can be filled in this body, what amount can be present in this body, the maximum amount can be present in the body will be the mass, will be the mass. So the mass will be the amount of matter present in the body, and the unit of the mass is kilogram. The unit of the mass is kilogram. That we can say that mass can be measured in the unit kilogram, kilogram, gram, it may be. And what is the weight? So weight, what is the weight? So we understand the weight. Weight is the product of mass and gravity. Weight is the product of mass and gravity. So what to understand, what is the difference between mass and weight? So we can understand these things very well, that mass cannot be changed. If you go anywhere, like mountain, like sea, like meadows, like grounds, you can go everywhere, but the mass cannot be changed. Mass will remain same. So mass cannot be changed. Mass can not be changed. But weight can be changed. But weight can be changed. The question arises now, why mass is fixed? Any object's mass is fixed, but the weight can be changed. Why? Because weight is dependent on gravity. Weight is dependent on gravity. Weight is dependent on gravity. So the weight is dependent on the gravity, then the weight, if we go from one place to another place, the gravity definitely will be changed. Normal gravity is 9.8, you already know, 9.8 meter per second square gravity. But if you go mountain, the gravity's amount will be changed. If you come to the plane, the gravity will be changed. And you already know, I think, on the moon, the weight is 6 times less than the weight on the Earth. If we go to the moon, why? Because the gravity is less there, is gravity less? By 1/6, so the weight is reduced by 1/6 on moon. So I think you understood what is volume, what is mass, what is weight. I think you understood clearly. Volume is the amount of space occupied by a certain 3D objects, and its unit is meter cube. And the body mass, mass is the amount of matter present in the objects. It depends on the position of the objects. Mass is the amount of matter present in the 3D objects or in the body. Mass of matter present in the 3D objects or in the body. So the mass cannot be changed, volume cannot be changed, but weight can be changed. Why? Weight changes because weight depends on the gravity. Weight is the product of mass and gravity, and gravity changes according to the positions, according to the places. So the weight can also be changed, and the unit of the weight is Newton. Unit of the weight is Newton. So these topics will be cleared, and we come to the topic, and topic is, you already know, topic is matter. In real, they start chemistry from this topic, matter. What is matter? Question arises, what is matter? Every student gives answer, what is matter? And every student says that the objects which has mass and occupies space is matter. The objects which occupies space and have mass is matter. Objects which occupy space and mass is matter. And so what are the matters? we what are we seeing? Everything is matter. What do we see? What we touch? What we catch? So dust is a matter. Well, obviously, dust is a matter. Is a pen, marker is a matter. Obviously, marker is a matter. And anything, board is a matter. Board also is a matter. Why? Because it has a space. It has a space. It has a mass. It occupies a space. It occupies the certain space of the ball. And this place, we can't touch the wall. We cut the ball here, but not here. Because it occupies the space and mass. It also have a mass. So, board is a matter. Anything which occupies space and have mass is matter. And we can see. And question arises, if we can't see anything, that cannot be a matter. If we are not able to touch anything, we're not able to catch anything, then will not be matter. No, it also can be matter. Example is air. Air, we cannot hold air. Non-touch. We cannot hold air. But it is also matter. Air is also matter. Air is a gaseous form of matter. You already know, I think. So, what is matter? Objects which occupy space and have mass is called matter. In the olden age, in the ancient age, our scientists said that the matter is made up of five basic components. Five basic components that are water, air, sky, earth. Water, air, sky, earth, and fire. In Hindi, it is called Vayu, Agni, Jal, Akash, Prithvi. These are the five components from which the matter is formed. So, matter. So, what is matter? So, matter is a certain things which occupy space and have mass is called matter. And we can catch the matter, we can touch the matter. And now, the question arises. On the properties of matter, matter can be classified, kaise classified in two ways. Matter can be classified in two ways. What are the ways? First way is on the basis of physical states and on the basis of chemical states or properties. So, matter can be classified in two ways. First, physical state base, on the physical property state base, and second, on the chemical properties base. So, on the basis of physical state, matter is classified into three states. What are? Solid states, liquid state, and gas state. So, on the basis of physical properties, physical state, matter can be classified into three states. Those are solid state, liquid state, and gas state. And on the basis of chemical properties, matter is also classified in three states. On the basis of chemical properties, matter is also classified in three states. So what are the three states? We understand one by one. So these are the physical state A, B, and C. And the chemical state is, first is element. Element. Second is compounds. And third is mixture. So let's be discuss one by one these things. But we want to discuss one thing before discussing this. The things is are that that love, affection, joy, sad, envy, etc. Are these matter? Love is matter? No. Affection is matter? No. Joy is matter? No. Sad is matter? No. Why? Question is why? They play a very important role in our lives, in our daily lives. Love, affection, joy, sad, envy, greatness, honesty. These are not matters. Why? Because these do not have occupied space. You know, what a love? 1 kilogram love. Have you heard? It is like joking, but love cannot be measured. How much love? You guys, my mother showed a lot of love. But how much? Kilogram, 2 kilogram, 3 kilogram cannot be measured. So love cannot be measured. Affection cannot be measured. Joy cannot be measured. Sad cannot be measured. So, but they play a very important role in our lives, but cannot be measured. So we have not units of these things. So these are not matters. These are not a matter. In English, you have already abstract nouns, you can say, if you learn in English, noun classification. So we come on the topic that on the basis of physical state, solid, liquid, and gas, and on the basis of chemical properties, chemical state, we can say elements, compounds, and mixtures. First, we will discuss the properties of matter. What is matter? First, we can understand matter is made up of particles. So, matter is made up of particles. Many particle constituents and form matter. So matter is made of particles, and you already know that everything around us made up of tiny particles. A small raindrop contains about 10^21 particles. 10^21 particles. Can you imagine? 10 means 10 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 21 times. A raindrop contains about 10^21 particles. We can say particles, we should not say the particles, we can say atoms or molecules. In place of particles, we can use atoms or molecules. So we can say a raindrop contains 10^21 atoms or molecules in one drop. So the matter is made up of many tiny particles. And another thing is evidence of particles in matter. Now we see evidence for particles in matter. contents of particles in matter. Evidence of particles in matter. How can you say that a matter has a many particles? For this, for proving this, we take an example: dissolving a solid in a liquid. Dissolving a solid in a liquid. Dissolving a solid in a liquid. For this, we take KMnO4. You already know this is also called potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate, KMnO4. If we take KMnO4 and we take a beaker, this is a beaker, and here solvent is water. Here solvent is water. This is water. H2O. Already know H2O. And when we dissolve, we already know that water is colorless. Water is colorless. Colorless. And KMnO4 has purple color. When what will happen? This is a beaker. It will take some time if we make properly. This is a beaker, and when we dissolve some crystals, some means two or three crystals of KMnO4. When we dissolve some crystals of KMnO4 here, suppose here, KMnO4 crystals are poured here in the bottom of the beaker. Then what will happen? After some time, you will see that the KMnO4 particles will spread over the whole solvent, over the whole particles in the water. And the colorless water will be colorful. How it happened? Means that the small amount of KMnO4 have many particles. Means KMnO4 there are lakhs particles or atoms or molecules. Those molecules automatically spread throughout the solution, throughout the water. Why? The solution was raised and we didn't apply any external force. We didn't stir it. But the whole particles continuously spread in whole the solution till the uniform composition is not formed. The particles, because KMnO4 is also have many particles and water also have many particles, and they mix with each other and form a colorful uniform solution of KMnO4 and water. So this shows that matter is made up of very tiny and small particles. Those are called atoms, and those atoms are continuously moving in the solution, in the compound, and uniform composition of the water is formed. So today's lecture is time is to end, and we will continue this topic in the next lecture. So we'll still remain. Thank you.